come back. TATAC Romania continues with another interesting project, JARVIS. It's something related to cars. It might be related to one of our first hacks we had today, the Sorry app. I don't know if you've seen the Sorry app. It is an interesting application about blocking cars and protecting your privacy as well. You have to show, you have to watch the
video. I'll have to watch the recording.
So your project is about a car assistant.
A car
assistant. I have with me Alex Mincu. He's the CEO and founder of Mount Software in Romania. Tell us more about your project.
So we thought of building an always available car assistant. Right now, well, actually, let's start with the motivation. So, first of all, it seems pretty obvious now that the first inclination of most people when they want to talk to a friend or a family member is to text them. And that hasn't come to businesses yet. And that needs to change because consumer, you need to go to the consumer and communicate with
them. Why do you think is this happening now? I'm changing the subject, but it's just, you know, I'm asking everybody this question.
Well, first of all, it's easier to text, and you do it in your own time and not on not when the other person wants you to.
But it seems to be the option of younger people. My dad still phones me, whatever. So he never texts me. So
yeah, because he hasn't discovered yet the benefits. That's one of them, and maybe learning to type on a mobile device is still pretty hard for him. So,
so you think it's a technology barrier? Okay. So now, of course, it's a reality.
Yeah. Okay. So the problem is that most people here and everywhere in the world buy a car, they pay lots of money for it, and they expect it to work without any issues, but that's not always the case. You have problems with your car, it can break down, it needs scheduled maintenance, it can display lots of unknown errors or error messages that you don't know what to do with. And the process of getting it fixed, or for example, if you have an accident, the process of getting it to a notarized mechanic or get a tow car, get a car replacement is very complicated. You need to do lots of steps. And this is the problem.
Is your app working if you're trying to send your car out in the space? So. No, you have some limitations.
So. We can integrate it with a SpaceX API.
With a SpaceX API, yeah. Right. Right.
They'll expose that soon. I'm pretty sure they will. So what if you could have a simple way to interact with your authorized reseller or your authorized service, and you don't have to wait in line for an operator to answer the phone. You have simple ways to get fixes for your problems, like make a reservation, set up a towing service, set up spare car delivery or rental car delivery. If your car displays an error you don't know how to fix, you can text and get more details there without looking through a big manual and getting the information you need to, or looking up an online PDF then searching through it. And regular maintenance can
Revision,
also be
yeah.
Scheduled easily. Okay, so what we've built is we've built a chatbot that's an interface for the business. And it can be exposed as an SMS interface, a mobile application chat, a chat that's embedded in your app from your car provider, a Facebook Messenger bot, or any other text-based interface.
All these are channels by which you can interact with your chatbot.
With your with the chatbot, yeah. Well, probably most people will interact with it as an SMS number. It's the easiest way to do it.
Yeah. The more reliable.
Yeah.
In cases you're out.
More reliable.
Yeah.
Okay. So the data flow is this: user sends us an SMS message, then we do natural language processing and understanding.
So I send free text.
Yeah, you just
flat tire and on my right front wheel, something like this. Just that.
Yeah.
So anybody can use it. It doesn't have to be.
Anybody can use it. Yeah. The chatbot needs to be trained, and it will be continuously trained from the messages it gets, and it will get better and better as people start using it in real life. We just have a few examples now of what can be built with it. And then after you understand the message and the user's request, we can then integrate with the service reservation, a tow car, a replacement car booking, or even the car or most onboard computer. And issue commands or get information from the car to give you more details.
So there's still room here for a black box for the SpaceX.
Yeah, that's
API.
For the SpaceX. So we want
in the next edition, we'll
next
come
iteration.
Up with updates, guys.
Next year. Okay, and the technologies we've used for getting SMS messages and doing some integrations here, you can have for the service reservation or replacement car booking, you can have an automated call and give them the information about the booking. So the user just says, okay, I want to book a car, and they get a call on their normal phone. And the operator can get all the information from the user. Okay, and some samples of how the solution looks. So this is the mobile app version, but we'll demo the SMS version. Okay, so this is the normal mobile app of your car.
You're driving one of those cars.
Yeah.
It's not any. Yeah.
It was easier just to get a picture with the car.
I don't have any copyright issue with that. So.
no problem. No copyright issues whatsoever. Okay, so now you just select talk with Jarvis, and then you get an interface that can tell you, like, give you examples of what the chatbot can do. And then you just say, okay, I need to service my car.
So there are predefined options for starting the...
Just examples.
Just an example of how
the customer can engage in the conversation. And then it just goes back and forth. I need to service my car. Okay, let me check what's wrong with it. It goes and checks with the car's onboard computer, sees when the service is due, then checks the next available reservation.
Can you get some geolocation of the guy sending that message to find closer?
If it's in the app, yeah. If not,
if it's
you
in the
can
SMS,
talk.
You cannot, right?
Yes, but you can talk with the car. That has an the car has an onboard.
It's
GPS.
A connected car,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, and you can get the location from that one. And you generally you already know the preferred location because that's where the customer actually bought the car.
Bought the car.
And then you just book the service reservation. Okay, and now we can actually
do a demo. So do we need to broke your car first?
No. We have an emulated mobile device
to
here
be,
that
to
I can
be more realistic.
I'd prefer not to. Okay. I have an emulated mobile device here, and I can say hi.
It's in English for the moment.
Yeah, it's in English for the moment. It can be in Romanian. Let me see if I can actually make this bigger. Maybe, yeah, something like that. Okay, so I lock my car. Well, that was a bug.
As I said, if you're not embarrassed with your MVP, it means it's not an MVP.
Exactly. The demo gods aren't with us here. So, okay.
If he would have answered you with the right answer, I might have suspected you of, you know, hard-coded this. So now we're pretty sure it's just your...
Let's try it again, actually.
Did I lock my car? What do you mean by that? You're not sure if you have locked your car by...
Yes.
Okay.
And
now he thinks it over and...
No. Okay. And please service my car.
That was quick. He really checked that.
No, that was a mocked API there.
Okay.
We don't have the integrations yet.
Yes.
But it will probably just send you a message that, okay, let's wait for a bit. Let me check everything and go and communicate with the car and all other services.
BMW guys wants to know your email address. Can we send it over? So it's fantastic that the global coverage this event has. No, they say they have connected cars and connected drive as well. So
yeah.
Get the email address.
Send them.
Yeah,
we can.
Alex
send them
will contact later on.
Yeah.
So this was done today or yesterday? Because I think yesterday you had some challenges with the APIs, trying to figure out how to call them, how to send basic SMS, basic voice calls.
Yeah, we've...
Most of this is done yesterday.
Some of it was done yesterday, and most of it was done today. The integrations were a problem, but once we figured out how everything works, it was pretty easy to do without actually using native telecom protocols. Everything. You just have normal web services.
That's the power and the beauty of programmable telecom, because it lets programmers use, you know, standard APIs, standard web hooks, instead of, you know, getting your hands dirty, going deep down inside the telecom protocols, which was a barrier years ago. And this kind of projects were not possible in 1 or 2 days. So basically, this is one of the messages of the event, to show people, to show our 10K audience now for the Romanian channel. Thank you, guys, that this is possible in just staying 2 days and having fun, having some pizza. And at the end of the day, you have a chatbot with some artificial intelligence connecting, you know, information from the chain of your service dealer, all the service representatives that can fix your car, or whenever there's a free spot to schedule for maintenance. And it's just a matter of having fun and doing great apps.
Yeah.
Seen that spark in your eye. Yeah. Right, so when I've asked this question to all the hacks that have potential, you know, commercial releases, do you plan on releasing some MVP after this TED hack, or is just a thing that came into your mind for the TED hack and it will stay like this?
It was a thing that came into our mind for the TED hack, but it's
not bad as a business opportunity as well, right?
Yeah, it's not bad as a business opportunity, so we'll probably go ahead and
Okay, so 10% for us, George, for that BMW.
For that BMW deal, yeah.
Okay, thank you. I mean, it's a fair price. Huh?
Yeah, it is.
So, tell us more about the architecture of your platform. We have some open source server-side backend processes.
It's just the
backend, a mix of APIs. How is it built?
Right now, it's built on Node.js microservices, just hooking all the data together and doing some NLP there for the chatbot, and trying to find the best answers and the logic. But it would probably need to grow into something much bigger once we actually put that into production.
Okay. Yeah, sounds good. It sounds like a viable product. I mean, have you Googled it up? Are there any products available on App Store?
Some brands have started using chatbots like this. Some, for example, in banking, Revolut has a pretty good chatbot that everybody is...
Automotive industry...
For the automotive industry, I don't know.
There are any products, it's Mercedes-Benz products or BMWs. Maybe you plan to do a generic chatbot that can have all of them and can be used by different users, no matter what cars they use.
I I sincerely doubt the automotive industry would like to integrate with the one that works with everybody.
So 20% from them. You need that niche, okay.
Yeah.
It's a great hack. Thank you for joining us.
And thank you for hosting the great event.
We had fun during these days.
Yeah.
I hope to see you next year. It's a great product. Sure. Maybe we can see it on App Store or on Google Play Store next year.
Yeah, hope so.
Thank you very much, Alex.
Thank you.
Take care.